Ladies and gentlemen, Chairman is now, the Cahirlip is now going to unveil a new seating which the Town Council has kindly provided to the town. Then after that, we're going to have a photograph taken of the current members of the Town Council and the former members that are here. So, and it's going to be taken here in front of the door just before we go back upstairs. So we're going to have the current and the former members just after the seats are unveiled. Thanks.
Sitting on the job, now, Pat.
Sitting down on the job.
Sitting down on the job.
Ready.
Could we get all the current members of the Town Council and the former members in here? We want to get a group photograph before we go.
Right, current members.
Yes.
Good to see you, Martin.
Oh, cheers, how are you?
How are you keeping? Long time no
see. Since I've seen
you. Oh, it's a good while now, yeah?
Is anybody else?
What in Carlisle?
Carlisle, of course. Okay, everybody, watch my camera, please. This won't be taken again. Okay, here we go. Lovely. Oh, keep watching, please. Lovely, keep watching. And up shamrocks when I shout one. 1, 2, 3, shamrocks!
We are on vacation.
We are on vacation.
And you've come to Mullingar.
Yes, we have.
And why you've come to Mullingar?
Well, we're travelling from Dublin to Donegal. But I'm in an Irish band in the United States.
Oh.
And we used to play the Man from Mullingar, so we were looking on the map and we thought, well, Annie, let's go through Mullingar. And we talked to a couple of bartenders here, and they never heard of their song, The Man from Mullingar.
Yes. Yeah. So. It's a very historic occasion because this is the end of the town council.
That's what we heard.
We're absolutely thrilled to. We just happened to have it. We're very interested in
the
politics.
You know what you should do? They're going to take a group photograph outside of it, aren't they?
We're after doing it.
Oh, you did it? All right.
No, on the table. No.
The table. Oh, I thought you were going to take a group one.
All right.
These guys are working hard.
Watch yourself.
We're so interested. Our families are we're here to look up some family.
One of these guys over here
from Ireland.
I'm sure you can go up there and watch. You want to go up there and watch?
What's going to happen up there?
They're going to have a kind of a ceremony.
We don't want to get in the way.
Oh, you want to get in the way? Just go up and watch.
We might want to. Can we just hang out for 5 or 10?
Yeah. Of course.
Right, that'd be lovely.
Yeah. Right.
Free wine.
Free wine. And there's free wine as well. Come on up. Come on up. It's the Irish welcome, so it is. It's the Mullingar welcome.
What are your names?
Yes. John.
I'm John.
John.
Nice to meet you,
Seamus.
And you're John.
I'm John as well.
Seamus. It's your first Seamus of the trip.
Oh, sorry. And your name is?
I'm Annie Walsh.
Annie and John Walsh.
We have Walsh's town out there.
Walsh's
town.
Don't mind those scrubbers. I'm the boss.
Yeah.
We knew that.
What is your name? Your name is David.
Don't forget to go look at the website now. Oh,
we definitely will.
MullingarShowcase.com.
We've got the card. We've got it.
Yeah, we're gonna. Right away, Davey. Sorry, Davey,
you're in the way. Yeah, of course I am.
Davey, your shoulders in the way.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Are you all settled now? I'd like to welcome everyone to the Market House here tonight. This is a very special function to mark the end of Mullingar Town Council after 158 years of existence. Before we start, we have a few apologies. One is from Deputy Willie Penrose. Jim Hearn, former county engineer, can't be with us. Niall Murphy, who is the former town engineer, he unfortunately can't be with us either. Councillor Peter Burke is also not going to be with us tonight. Tonight, I'd like to welcome in particular former members of the Town Council and also former staff of Westmeath County Council who at different times were involved in some way or another with the Town Council. Organising this evening's event was coordinated by a small group which included Councillor Collins, the Cathaoirleach, Councillor Collentine, Councillor Illingworth, Declan Leonard and myself. However, a lot of other people were also involved in helping us get to tonight. I'd like to thank the following staff of the Mullingar Area Office, in particular Paul McCool, Murty Hanley, Pat Kavanagh and Martin Murray, all of whom were involved in procuring and providing the seating outside, as well as the plaque in the hallway and the general appearance of the Market House. I'd also like to extend thanks to Paula O'Dornan from Westmeath County Library, who put a lot of work into the booklet on the history of the Town Council. Thanks also to Dominic Evans and Sean Murphy from the Council in helping to set up the room here tonight for the function. And last but not least, I'd like to thank Derek, who as always has done a great job in preparing and serving refreshments tonight. Now we have a number of speakers this evening, but now I call formally on the Cathaoirleach of the Town Council, Councillor Pat Collins, to address you.
Reverend Fathers, County Manager Pat Gallagher, ladies and gentlemen, as the last Cathaoirleach, on behalf of my council colleagues, I extend a special welcome to you all to the Market House this evening for this reception to mark the dissolution of our town council following last Friday's local government elections. I would like to especially welcome the former members of this body and also the retired members of the Executive of Westmeath County Council who have served us here over the last number of years. In relation to last Friday's elections, could I take this opportunity to congratulate all who were successful and commiserations to the candidates who failed to make it past the winning post. I wish all our re-elected and new councillors on Westmeath County Council the best of luck as they set out on their five-year term. I hope that their combined talents, along with our county manager and the executive of Westmeath County Council, will provide a platform to tackle the many difficulties that presently exist in local government, and that the decisions they make will always be for the good of the people of Westmeath, who are now privileged to represent. A couple of months ago, the members decided to elect a subcommittee of Councillor Illingworth, Councillor Collentine and myself as Cathaoirleach, to meet and come back with proposals as to what would be a fitting legacy for this council to leave to the people of Mullingar on our dissolution. Following our deliberations at a number of meetings with the help of our town clerk Caroline and Declan Leonard, we decided that the area outside of this historic building was badly in need of seating. We have made a start this evening with the unveiling of two seats, and it's our fervent hope that the new members of Westmeath County Council will take matters further in time to come by providing additional seating elsewhere in the square to complement what has just been unveiled. The general area of the Market Square is very busy nowadays, with many tourists visiting the statue of the late and great Joe Dolan. So additional seating would be a great help, particularly for elderly people who have nowhere to sit. We also decided that the placing of a plaque in the lobby indicating that this building has served as the headquarters and meeting place of the Town Council for the last number of years was a requirement, as there are a number of visitors to this building on a daily basis using the facilities of the Tourism Information Centre. It is also very important that the history of any organisation or body is documented, so we have produced a booklet which gives a flavour of the activities of this council going back over the last 158 years. It is intended that this booklet will be available going forward as a link on the website of Westmeath County Council. The work that went into this booklet is very much down to Ruth Illingworth, our local historian and a member of this current council. I'm sure that Ruth and the other members will agree that the help and assistance afforded to us by Paula and the staff in the library in bringing this part of the project to conclusion is very much appreciated. Later in the proceedings, Ruth will be giving us a short talk on the history of this council, and I am sure that the audience here this evening will find Ruth's presentation both informative and interesting. I would like to extend a sincere thank you to Caroline, our town clerk, for all her coordinating and organising over the last few weeks to ensure the smooth running of the event this evening. All our behind-the-scenes work has culminated in a fantastic reception, which I'm sure that everybody is enjoying so far. Also, a special thanks to Derek for the organising of the refreshments for the reception, and on previous occasions that he has done it for the Town Council.
Once again, I'm delighted to see so many people here, to truly representative now of the townspeople now in Mullingar. I regret very much now the demise now of Mullingar Town Commissioners and Mullingar Town Council. But who knows what the future will bring now in the context now of local government reform. Thank you, Norm.
Reverend Bader, County Manager, members of staff, former members of staff, my fellow council colleagues and former council colleagues, and family and friends, you're all very welcome here to the Market House tonight. I want to firstly compliment the organising committee, Cathaoirleach and Caroline and Billy and Ruth, for putting together this night tonight. It was certainly a very important occasion. Disappointing that Mullingar Town Council will be no more in the coming days, because certainly a town the size of Mullingar has had fantastic representation across the political spectrum. And when you look around the room at the various photographs of the various members, and there's many of them here tonight, they've served with great distinction on behalf of the people of Mullingar, have worked for the people of Mullingar. And I did make the prediction when these changes came in that Mullingar would be the poorer because there would be less representation for them, and that will be the case. I want to offer my congratulations to all those that were successful last Friday, and my commiserations to those who were unsuccessful. Certainly the council chamber will be a different place, and certainly some good friends have not made it back, but certainly I want to congratulate everybody. Democracy was at work, and you know, as Councillor Mick has said, it'll be a very different chamber when we go down there on Friday week. But that's what the people have spoken. We now have to go out and do the job that we've been elected to do. To the staff, Caroline in particular, has been an absolute Trojan to this town council for the last number of years. And, you know, I've always said she's the unsung hero, and she is the unsung hero, because if the motion and questions are late, the text arrives, get your stuff in. You know, when there's an event like this, and we've had so many events down the years, we've seen so many great people that have done so much for Mullingar Town and put us on the map, be it on the sporting, musical, literature, whatever it is. Caroline was always at the forefront of organising the event, and certainly with the help of the Cathaoirleach, and would be Declan at the moment, who has had to listen to a lot of hot air over the years, and prior to that, George and Ray and Dave. But certainly, you know, it's been a fantastic support, and I will miss Mullingar Town Council. I came in here as a very raw 28-year-old back in 1999, January 1999, I'll never forget it, and I was as nervous as hell, and certainly it was a baptism of fire, but it stood me in good stead. I was surrounded by good, experienced people, and it became a good family, because bar the time of elections, we're all here to work for the town, we're all here to work for the people of Mullingar, and that will continue. I hope you enjoy the rest of the night, and as I said, I do regret the demise of Mullingar Town Council, but we have to look forward, and certainly the new municipal areas of Mullingar Kilbeg and Mullingar Cool will now come into play, and you know, we see what the future holds. Thank you.
Councillor Illingworth.
Cathaoirleach, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Fine Gael group, which means really myself and Councillor Peter Burke, I'd just like to say a few words. Peter can't be here tonight, but he himself made a little bit of history by being the youngest ever Cathaoirleach of this body, as indeed he was the youngest ever Cathaoirleach of Westmeath County Council to date. And again, I share the sadness of the other speakers tonight at the loss of this body which for so long was the voice of Mullingar. We were the elected representatives of this town, and there is no greater privilege than any person can ever aspire to in this country than to be an elected representative of the people. And some of us also had the extraordinary privilege of being the Cathaoirleach of this body, of being the first citizen of this town. And that was an extraordinary achievement, an extraordinary privilege. So on behalf of Councillor Peter Burke and myself, I'd like to concur with what Ken said. I'd like to thank Caroline very much for her service over the years, the 10 years I was on this council. We could not have done our job without Caroline. And I'd like to thank Declan and Ray and all the other administrative staff of the County Council who came to our meetings, who answered our questions, who dealt with sort of sometimes the difficult sort of issues that we raised. Again, without the staff of the County Council, we would not have been able to do the work as the democratically elected representatives of the people of this town. So on behalf of Peter and myself, I'd like to thank all those who helped us over the years to carry out our work. I think we can all be proud of what Mullingar Town Council achieved over the years. And it's, I think we've all felt it's been a privilege to serve on this body. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much to the whips. I will now ask the County Manager, Pat Gallagher, to address you.
Cathaoirleach, Chór Lóirí is a renewal of the air in their tua. Are those who are the waifus of the wild and Cathaoirleach, Agustin Corla, as up than Quirra Behan Shaw, Umhranona, Egan Oakhide, Starrow Shaw. I would like to be associated with the remarks of his previous speakers, in recognising the contribution that Mullingar Town Council has made to the civic life and to the development of the town since its inception. I'm particularly impressed with Councillor Illingworth's summary of town government since the mid-19th century here in Mullingar in tonight's official programme. And I suppose what it shows is that town government and municipal government, I suppose, goes through changes from time to time. And we're currently going through a very significant change in relation to municipal government as well. However, despite those changes, its job, its task remains the same. That is to represent the community, to serve the community, and to provide leadership to the community. And certainly, Mullingar Town Council, and before that, the Town Commissioners, did that with distinction. And it is fitting, and I'd like to compliment the elected members of the Town Council on choosing to have this formal occasion here this evening to recognise the contribution of the, I suppose, the body itself, but also the people of the town who received the democratic mandate from the local community in successive elections to represent them. Many things change. The town council will be no more from midnight on Saturday night, and as I said to Caroline on the way in, county manager will be no more, the town clerk will be no more. We'll have different names. And I suppose while the town council will not be here officially, we are moving forward to a new structure where Mullingar and its hinterland will have a municipal district, which will have a very important job to do in the future. And in acknowledging and thanking the current and previous members of the town council here, in acknowledging the work of the present and previous staff of the council in supporting Mullingar Town Council, I would like, on behalf of the staff, to commit ourselves in the future to continuing to work with the new municipal district members in Mullingar as they represent the community at two levels. Firstly, at municipal district level, and then take the concerns of the district forward for further engagement at county level. We will continue to support the members in doing your job. Finally, at Cathaoirleach, I would like to wish those elected members who are retiring on this occasion the very best of health and happiness in the future. And for those members who will continue to work as members of the municipal district and as members of Westmead County Council, I look forward to continuing to work with you in the future. Ramila Mahabib Blair.
Thank you, Manager. Okay, we're now going to call on all of the members, both past and present, to come forward when their name is called. We're going to present each member with a certificate which outlines their service to Mullingar Town Council. So I'll call out the name and the Cathaoirleach will formally present each member. Jim Burke. Dennis Burke. Frank McKeown. Pat Whelan. Paul McGrath. Thanks very much. Martin Hines. Michael Dollard. Bill Collentine. Ken Glynn. Desi Cornelli. Ruth Illingworth. Jerry Sheridan. And Councillor Collins, your own, I'll present that to you. Councillor Davids is also here, but I don't think he's made it here yet. Now, we've more gifts to give away. At the end of February, the county manager came along to our February meeting, and we had a formal photograph taken of the last members of the town council. So we've had the photograph framed for each of the current members of the town council, and we're now going to present each of the members with a copy of the picture. So if the current members want to come forward, and the Cahirlock will formally present one. Councillor Glynn. Councillor Illingworth. Councillor Dollard. Councillor Carnelli. Councillor Collentine. Councillor Sheridan. And Councillor Collins, this one's also for you.